Don't you remember the rain, go away, come again another day nursery rhyme? This is probably the perfect nursery rhyme to sing when the rain is pouring down outside. But do you know how rain works? How we can make rain artificially? And why some countries facing difficulty to produce artificial rain? You will see all these things in this video. This is Eco Snooki, your nature conservation and energy saving partner and your sustainable lifestyle supporter. We know how the process of rain works. It starts from evaporating of water from the sea or any other water body. Then it travels upstream as the wind rises high in the troposphere, which is the bottom layer of atmosphere, causing some drops to merge, and then this merging process goes on, and when the thickness of the drop come in the vicinity of 0.1 millimeters, they cannot float up there anymore, and finally we get bestowed by the almighty rain. But then why do we have to tackle drought? Often there are clouds but no rain. Well, one could try to make it rain. And that's where artificial rainfall comes along. When the temperature of clouds is close to zero, and there might be crystals of ice in it. Then water vapors do not condense to its liquid form. This is metallized by the cloud seeding, and once again it rain, but this time artificially. There are three stages for artificial rain. First is agitation. This stage includes the use of chemicals to stimulate the air mass upwind of target area to rise and form clouds. These chemicals absorbs the water vapor and helps in the process of condensation. Chemicals like calcium oxide, compound of urea and ammonium nitrate or chloride, calcium carbonate, are used in this stage. Second one is building up stage. In this stage, the mass of the cloud is built up by urea, dry ice, kitchen salt, etc. to increase the density of the clouds. And the final stage is seeding. Aircrafts are deployed to inject silver iodide and dry ice to reach the most unbalanced status, which eventually leads to the formulation of droplets and make them fall as raindrops. This method was discovered by Dr. Bernard Vonnegut in 1971. Cloud seeding methods have been used throughout the world, including the United States, United Arab Emirates, China, India, Russia, and many other countries. When torrential rains flooded downtown Dubai earlier on 2019, the United Arab Emirates' zealous embrace of cloud seeding was blamed by some. So if cloud seeding can cause a desert to flood, why can't Australia use the technology to break the drought? The answer is surprisingly simple. For cloud seeding to produce rain, you need moisture to begin with and cloud. Australia at present is in short supply of both, and even if more clouds begin to make an appearance in the Australian sky, chances are they will not be the right type. Seeding is only likely to be effective when used on clouds containing extremely cold tiny droplets of water, which is between minus 5 and minus 10 degrees Celsius, that have failed to convert to ice but are too small to fall as precipitation. Seeding will help them to become heavy and to fall. So how much it will cost for a single artificial rain project? In the United Arab Emirates, cloud seeding first began as in 2010 as a project by weather authorities to create artificial rain. The project, which began in July 2010 and cost US$11 million, has been successful in creating rainstorms in the Dubai and Abu Dhabi deserts. China is poured $168 million into a program aimed at making it rain in its usually arid northwestern region. We have regions of our planet that are difficult for human survival because there is a lack of moisture present. Although we don't want to turn every desert green, the work of cloud seeding creates the potential for more precipitation. If we use this method along mountain ranges where the snowpack serves as the water supply for local communities, then it is possible to make more land suitable for living because we have additional resources available to use consistently. Even though the artificial raining work have some disadvantages like high cost, effectiveness according to climate, etc., this process will get more fame in coming years.